First, I'll give some, we'll see the mixture already done, just a review of mixture. So what is a mixture? Can anybody speak? What is the mixture? You can read the screen. Yes, Ellen, can you speak? What is the mixture?
Mixture is a combination of two or more substances that do not combine chemically but remain the same individual substance and can be separated by physical
means. Okay, that is called as mixture. Today we are going to start the topic solution from 3A. I have sent in your group. I think everybody has written that. Okay, just come to the directly to the topic, that is solution. So why started from the mixture? Because you have to understand, what do you mean by mixture? Mixture are of two types. One is homogeneous, another is heterogeneous. Okay. Let us see a look. It is a combination of two or more substances that do not combine chemically. Okay. That do not combine chemically. Suppose we are using mixture. If you will mix sand, salt, everything, if you will mix, this is called as mixture. Means any ratio, there is no fixed ratio of mixture, okay? Because they do not combine chemically, there will be no chemical reaction. So the individual substance will be separated by the, you can use any physical method to separate themselves, okay? And mixture are of two types. One is homogeneous, another one is heterogeneous. Okay, now what do you mean by homogeneous and heterogeneous? Let us understand first. Heterogeneous mixture means it consists of different substance. Suppose in any kind of substance, whether it is maybe solid, liquid or gaseous state. Okay, so you can separate it by filtering. Suppose you are adding salt or water, salt, sand and water, everything mixed together. So it is called as a mixture, heterogeneous mixture. And how you can separate? You can separate by filtering. Some examples of those kind of mixture means heterogeneous mixtures are, you can see this is called as heterogeneous mixture. Here we can see mixture of dry fruits. Okay, it is called as heterogeneous mixture. There is no fixed ratio, and even we can use physical method by hand picking. You can separate the constituent of the mixture, heterogeneous mixture. Okay. Next is homogeneous. Homogeneous mixture means, homo means same. Have you heard the name homo? Homo means same. Same. So, okay. So, homogeneous mixture means the, which looks like uniform, means same. If you will mix a spoon of sugar into the water, can the particles of sugar will be visible after dissolving it? Can you see the particle? Yes,
ma'am.
No, you can't see.
No, ma'am.
No, we can't see because it is called as uniform. It looks like uniform. Everywhere it looks like same. So you are unable to say whether where is sugar and where is water in it. So like means this is called as uniform. Uniform, we are using in the terms of school, we are using uniform. Uniform, what is the meaning of uniform? So uni and form. So it's look similar to everywhere. Okay, if you will go to a school, when you were going to the school, you were wearing uniform. So it's look similar. If you can identify, yeah, these are the children of from this school. How you can identify with their uniform? Okay, so this is called as uniform, which looks like similar or same. So has the same uniform means appearance or composition throughout, maintains one phase in any phase. It either be solid, liquid or gas. You can see the example of salt water. Salt is mixed into the water and we can't see the particles of salt where it is dissolved into the water. So we can say it is a uniform mixture. Did you understand the term uniform? Because this term is important to understand the solution. Now come to the solution. come to the point. Okay, so solution, what do you mean by solution? Let us understand, solution is a mixture. First, I started from mixture. That's why you should understand what is mixture. Mixture are of two types that we studied, heterogeneous and homogeneous. Here, solution, which is a mixture of two or more substances that is identical throughout, it is called as homogeneous mixture. Okay, so it can be separated physically by the physical mean. Now, let us see the example. You can see here, solution which is a mixture of two or more substances which is identical throughout the homogeneous. Homogeneous means it looks similar everywhere. It is composed of, solution is composed of two. What is these two are? Solute and solvent. Solute and solvent. Okay. So, and what do you mean by solute and solvent? That we will learn now. So, substance which you are using in less quantity, okay, which you are using in less quantity, it is called as solute. Okay, suppose if you are adding taking a sugar solution. So, whatever you are taking in less quantity is called as solute. So, in sugar solution, tell me, what is the solute in sugar solution? What is the solute in sugar? Means the sugar solution, how it mix? You are taking sugar and then you are mixing it with water. After mixing it, you will get the sugar solution. Okay. And in sugar solution means whatever you are taking in small amount is called as solute, and which you are taking in large amount is called as solvent. Okay. It is a simple term. In another term, you can say the substance which is being dissolved means which is being dissolved, okay, which dissolved to that is called as solvent. So in sugar solution, can you say what is the solute here?
Sugar.
Yes, sugar is the solute because sugar is dissolving. It's losing the identity inside the water. Okay, and who dissolved the sugar? Water. So water is called as what?
Solvent.
So it is called as solvent. Okay. It is solvent and this is called as solution. And this is called as solution. Sugar is the solute. Water is the solvent. Okay. Children, mute yourself. Those who are still unmuted, if only time of answer, you can unmute yourself. Okay. Because background noises are disturbing the class. Let us understand. I'm taking one example of tea. Okay. So how do you make tea? We are adding tea mix. Okay. Tea mix. Suppose you are making a iced tea, means chilled tea. So take one pouch of iced tea mix as a solute, okay? And where will you dissolve? Into the water. Into the water. You are dissolving into the water, means iced tea solution. And what is the solvent here? The solvent is water, because everything you are dissolving in water. So water is called as solvent. Even water is called as universal solvent that we have studied in the introduction. In previous class, water is called as universal solvent, okay? So, which is infused in it. So, iced tea mix is infused into the water and gives the iced tea. So, iced tea called as a solution. Here, iced tea called as a solution. And water is the solvent here. And what is the solute? Iced tea mix. Iced tea mix is called the solution. I hope you all understood till here. Let's.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Good. Let's move to the parts of solution. What are the parts of solution? So the main parts of solutions are solvent and solute. Only two parts are there, solute and solvent. Okay. And what is the solvent? As I told, solvent is the largest part of the solution. Suppose if you are taking an example of sugar water, whatever you are taking in large amount, that is called as solvent. And the solute, which you are taking in small amount, which is the smallest part of solution, is called is called solute. Okay, now types of solution. So come to the types of solution. So solutions may be in gaseous solution. You can see the example of gaseous solution. It is like gaseous example of gaseous solution is air. Air is the solution. Which kind of solution? It is a mixture of oxygen and nitrogen. So it is called as solution. So air is the example of gaseous solution. Another example of liquid solution, that are drinks. Many various kind of drink, any kind of drink. Okay, so it mix means whatever you are mixing in drink. Suppose you are making lemonade. So whatever the mix you are using and where you are mixing into the water. So it is called as liquid solution. And some are solid solution. Solid solutions means what? That are alloys. Alloys, which are the mixture of two or three metals or non-metals. So steel is an alloy, brass is an alloy. So these are the solid solution. Okay, these are the solid solution. Now, concentration, come to the term that is concentration. What do you mean by concentration? You heard this word earlier, concentration. Concentration means, suppose if you will take one glass of water and you will add 1 teaspoon of sugar in it, okay? Can you add 2 or 3 more tablespoon of sugar in it and it will dissolve? Can you dissolve more sugar into the water?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, you can dissolve as much quantity as you want. Okay. Why? This is called the concentration. Concentration means what? The amount of solute dissolved in a solvent at a given temperature. Means at normal temperature, suppose you are taking one glass of water, okay, and you added sugar into it. You have to dissolve the sugar until it stop dissolving into it. So you have to dissolve more and more sugar till that it stop dissolving. So there is no more quantity to dissolve into it. Okay. So how will you increase the solubility? If you will heat this solution again, then you can add some more sugar into it. Okay. So the described dilute. Dilute means what? Dilute means it has low concentration. We are using two kind of acids in our laboratory. One is dilute and one is concentrated. Okay, dilute means what? If we are using in the terms of in mixture with water, suppose dilute hydrochloric acid. So dilute hydrochloric acid means you are adding hydrochloric acid means you added some amount of water in it. Okay. And if you are adding water into it and then preserve it, that is called as dilute acid. Okay. But the purest form means without adding water, that is called as concentrated acid, which is highly stronger than the diluted. Concentrated, any kind of concentrated acid, which is stronger than the diluted one. Because diluted, a part of water we have added to decrease the concentration. If you want to decrease the concentration, you have to add some amount of water in it. Okay, so describe dilute. It has a low concentration of solute into solid dissolve. So if you are taking one spoon of sugar into the water, that is called as low concentrated. And suppose you are adding more and more sugar, how you increase the amount of sugar into it? So you are increasing the concentration of the solution. Okay, so you are increasing the concentration. So describe concentrated if it has the high concentration of solute dissolved. Suppose this much amount of solute you have dissolved and now you added this much amount of solute, which is more concentrated here. How much more you are adding, that is called more concentrated. Did you understand the term concentrated? What is meant by concentration? Yes, then we will move to the next part after the concentration. So we understood the concentration. So after the concentration, these three types of solutions we have to study. One is called as unsaturated solution, one is called saturated, another one is supersaturated. So what do we mean by supersaturated, unsaturated and saturated solution? So here we are taking some example of unsaturated solution, means it has less than the maximum concentration of solute dissolved. Okay, so if you are using very less amount of solute in it, then it is called as unsaturated solution, means it has capacity to dissolve more but you are adding less. Okay, means it has capacity to still, it can dissolve more solute in it, but you are using very less solute. That kind of solution which has capacity to dissolve more are called unsaturated solution. Okay, now what do you mean by saturated? Saturated, which has the maximum concentration. Maximum concentration means it has reached, is the concentration, how much amount of solute you are adding into the solution. So it is related to that. If it is highly concentrated, it is called as saturated solution. Okay. Next is supersaturated. Okay. Supersaturated means what? So no more solute can dissolve. Okay. By any means, suppose if you are hungry, you want to eat, okay, you have to eat something, and I given suppose it is lunch time, so I'm giving you lunch. So after the lunch, you got your favorite dish. So what will you do? So you will think, yeah, a little bit place is there in my stomach, so I can eat some more. So because it is your favorite dish, so you will try to eat. So that is called as, means you already had your lunch, but still you are, that the condition means already had the lunch, that is called as unsaturated. You ate the lunch, but suppose maybe it whatever you ate which is not of your choice, so but that's why you ate something. But after the lunch you are getting something which is your favorite snacks or favorite anything, so you think again you can eat some more, so that is that time you ate that one. Okay, so after that condition came to, after the lunch you are adding some snacks of your choice, that is called as saturation. So you are filling, now you are filled. Okay, so now after this again I given you some sweets. Okay, so you are already filled, but again you want to try something. Okay, because sweets we can have some more. Okay, so after the sweets, if again I'll tell you come and lunch with me, so will you accept that? So these three,
after no,
these, no, why? Because you got super saturated now, but means your stomach is means more than had how much is your capacity. So that is called as super saturation in general terms. Okay. So in solution also, in unsaturated means it can dissolve some more. Saturated means it same temperature, it can't dissolve more. Okay. So some solid particles are still there in bottom. Okay, it means it can't dissolve. I mean, suppose you are adding sugar and after some times what happens, it can't dissolve more. So sometimes it still undissolved into the water. Bottom, it will settle down. And if you will heat that solution, if you will heat again, then again it's increased the solubility, and that particles which were settled down into the bottom start dissolving into it and contains more dissolved solute than normally possible. So usually requires to increase the temperature followed by cooling. So you have to increase the temperature. So what will you get? You will get the sugar syrup. You will get the sugar syrup. I'm taking example of sugar because it is easily, you can see in your kitchen, while making some sweets, we are increasing the concentration, how much thickness we want for our sugar syrup. So you can understand unsaturated, saturated and supersaturated. Did you understand all these three terms? What do you mean by saturation, unsaturation and supersaturation? Means no more particles can dissolve further, that is called supersaturation state. Means you ate more than how much you want, but means more than. So you can speak, I can't eat more. Even whatever you give, I can't eat one single piece because already I am super saturated now. Did you understand the condition? Saturations, condition, three situations. Now come to the solubility. I use the term solubility here. So what do you mean by solubility? So if you will see the solubility, the amount of solute, the solubility, which it means the amount of solute that dissolves into a certain amount of a solvent at a given temperature and pressure to produce a saturated solution. Suppose given temperature, it means what? Suppose we are using the amount of solute dissolved into concentration amount. We are taking 1 liter of water. This is a 1 liter of water. Okay, 1 liter. 1 liter means, okay, so, and you are taking 1 kg of sugar. 1 kg of sugar. And then you started dissolving into the water, 1 liter of water. So the amount, Ulas, do you want to ask something? You raise the hand. If you want, you can ask. Unmute yourself and ask. So the amount of solute that dissolve in a certain amount of a solvent at a given temperature and pressure to produce saturated solution. See, you are adding 1 kg of sugar into the 1 liter of water. Dissolve means its dissolution capacity. So whatever amount of solute dissolves in a certain amount of solvent, suppose certain amount means, suppose you are taking example of 1 liter. Okay, this is called a certain amount. And the solute, amount of solute that you are adding 1 kg, 1 kg, okay, at a given temperature, suppose on it in room temperature, we are dissolving 1 kg of sugar into 1 liter of water, okay. So it is called a saturated solution without changing the temperature. Now, let us understand some factors which are related. So factors which are related into the solubility, which affecting the solubility of a solid. So as I told, if you will increase the temperature, if you will increase the temperature, of what? If you will increase the temperature, sometimes what happens, we dissolve the sugar into water, but it stopped dissolving into it. After adding some amount of sugar, it will stop dissolving it. But if you will increase the temperature, again, it will start dissolving more solute in it. So increase the temperature causes solid to dissolve faster. Even if you want to make sugar solution, if you will take a cold water and hot water, okay, in both the case, in which case you can dissolve sugar fast, cold water or hot water?
Mom, hot water.
Hot water. So why? Because temperature which affect the solubility. Okay, next is shaking. So if you just simple add the solute into the solvent, will it dissolve itself? Yeah, it will dissolve, but it will take some time. But if you will stir the solution continuously. So why we are shaking? We are shaking means it causes the solid to dissolve faster. If you will shake it, or otherwise if you will stir it, it will increase the solubility. It will solute can dissolve faster. Even particle size. Sometimes we are using in some of the sweet dishes, we are using sugar powder. At the place of sugar, we are using sugar powder. Why? Because the particle size matters. Particle size matters means, so how much smaller particles dissolve faster? Because they have more surface area. The particles of solid as compared to the, which will dissolve fast, sugar or sugar powder? Which will dissolve faster sugar into the
powder.
Water? Sugar powder. Why? Because here, this surface area, which is more in sugar powder. So increasing the amount of solid does not increase the rate of dissolving. Okay. So whatever amount, if you will increase the amount of solute, it doesn't increase the rate of dissolving. Whatever will be the rate will be the same. So rate will increase by the temperature, by the shaking, or by the particle size. These all are the factors which affect the solution process. Let us come to the miscible and immiscible. Miscible liquids means what? So the liquids which can easily dissolve one another. Suppose if you will take water and milk, you can't identify whether where is water and where is milk. It is called as miscible liquids. Okay, immiscible means what? They are not easily miscible to each other. Like if you are adding oil into the water, which is immiscible. You can see in these two test tubes, these are miscible liquids. Okay, which can mix easily. Okay, and immiscible means what? You are adding oil into the water. What happens? Oil will float over the water. That is called as immiscible. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
So here, see the example of miscible and immiscible. Now, polarity and dissolving. I don't know, polarity you have to learn or not in your textbook. It is there or not? Polarity is there. Okay. Do you have textbook with you?
Yes, ma'am.
Everybody is having. So this meeting will end. So I am ending this meet now. And bring your textbook and again rejoin with the same link because only few times has left. That's why you just rejoin with the same link. Okay, only 7 minutes left. That's why you have to rejoin with the same link. Okay, I'll stop this. Don't go anywhere and join fast.